Hello everyone, welcome to Study ETech. This is video lecture series on basic electrical engineering, and in lecture 2 we are going to discuss about basic chopper circuit. But before exactly starting the lecture, let's have a look on the important things. Well, they are like this. Right now please pause the video and read all these things carefully. I hope that these things, following these things, will be very much important for you, and you will get benefit if you follow all these things. Okay. I hope you have done that. Okay. So let's start now. So we are going to learn about the chopper circuit. So before coming to the basic chopper circuit, the function of chopper, that we must understand. That is, from a fixed DC voltage we get variable DC voltage. That is the objective. Okay, so this is the chopper circuit. We understand input DC, the output is, or input is a fixed DC voltage, the output is a variable DC voltage. It's like if you give 24 volt here, you can get 12 volt or 15 volt or etc. anything. In fact, you can get the voltage more than 24, or you can get the voltage less than 24 also. Okay, it's like transformer in AC. Okay, so but it is DC. So what happens in the transformer, depending on the number of turns, you get the higher voltage or lower voltage in the secondary side. So here the output voltage, you get either 15, 24, or you can get 30 volt. So what I'm trying to mean is that you can get the voltage output that is less than 24, that may be, or that may be more than 24 also, depending on the factor called delta or duty cycle. Here in the transformer, the factor is the number of turns. So they are similar. Okay, the number of turns in the transformer which decides the output voltage will be lower or the higher than the input voltage, and in the chopper it is about the delta or the duty cycle. Okay, I hope the objective of the of this chopper circuit is clear to you. Okay, so now we can take the circuit. I'm going to next page. Okay, so here we take the circuit diagram. How does it look like? The circuit is very simple. I'm telling you, this is a very simple. If you have understood the AC to DC conversion, this is very, very easy here. As you know, you have studied AC to DC conversion rectifier. Their AC is their alternating voltage, then it is being pulsating DC. So many things are there, but here it is not, those things are there. But it is very simple here. Look what I do here. The input voltage we are taking is a DC voltage. Okay, so this is a, we call the EDC, input DC voltage. Now basic chopper circuit, to draw the basic chopper circuit, what I do, I take a switch. This is our switch S, and here we connect a resistance which we are treating as a load. Okay, and this is a R value, let's say the output voltage being VO. Okay, now the switch will having two state, one is 0, one is 1, meaning this is off state and this is being on state. So whenever the switch is closed, something like that, what will happen? The current will flow through this resistance, or we can say this EDC is appearing across the this load resistance. Okay, so the voltage that we will get here, it will look like, let us change the background, it will be better, I think so. Okay. So what I do, we take a we will draw the switching of this switch. Okay, so here the diagram. Okay, so what we do, we will make the switches. Okay, let us take the line. The switch is from the zero to up to this. Let us say the switch is on. Okay, and from this point, the switch is off. Okay, clear, I think. And I have done a mistake. So sorry. Now, something like that. Okay, up to this, switch is on, and here the switch is off. Okay. Here I will draw the output voltage. The output voltage will be, let us say this is a EDC. Let's say this level is EDC. So up to this point, I will get the EDC voltage because switch is closed. The circuit is something like the EDC is connected to the R. So I will get the output voltage EDC, and from here I will get the zero voltage. Okay. Then again I will get the EDC here, then again zero. This sort of voltage we will get at the resistance, we are calling the load. Okay. Now look what I do. This voltage, we can calculate what is the average of this voltage. Let us say this is our, let us change the color. So this voltage is VO and this level is EDC. What is the average? Okay, so to calculate the average, let us do the VO average. What will it be? So one more thing I want to mention here, that is up to this, let us say the on, T on, and here this duration is T off, and at this point is capital T. So meaning this T on plus T off constitutes the capital T, the time period. Again, this is T on, T off, again this is T, sorry, this will be 2T. So you understand, I hope so. Periodically we are switching this, we are making this switch on and off periodically. So this is the switch. Now, what I am trying to say is that this the voltage that is VO, let us calculate the average. What will be the average value? Okay, so definitely it will be, so this voltage is EDC into T on plus 0 into T off divided by T on plus T off. So what is it? It will be T on by capital T into EDC. We can call it delta into EDC. Okay. So what is delta? This delta is called duty ratio. Delta is called what I have written. well, let us erase it. Okay, so this is called the duty ratio. Okay, sometimes it is called duty cycle. So if we take this to be one, and no, what I'm trying to say is that this delta can be 0 to 1, right? So if delta, as for example, delta equal to say 0.7, okay, so what the voltage I will get at the output as average voltage, VO average, it will be 0.7 into EDC. Let us say EDC equal to 100 volt. Okay, so what I will get, the output average voltage will be 70 volt. Similarly, by changing the value of delta, the voltage whatever I can get. Okay, So I will tell you how to get more than 100 volt later on. Okay, so now this is the basic circuit, but problem is that, well, one more thing, what will be the current? Okay, so let us take different color. The current will be this EDC by R, because in this circuit there is nothing, only R is there. R may be, let's say, 10 ohms. Okay, so 10 ohms. So EDC by 100 by R. So this will be EDC by R. Okay, okay. Let us take the line. So it will be EDC by R. Okay. So this, sorry. So this will be EDC by R. EDC by R. Okay. Again here it will be EDC by R. Again here it will be EDC by R. But have you seen the problem here? What I try to say is that you get the voltages, which is here the voltage is there, here the voltage is not there. Again, the current is there, EDC by R, and there is no current. So in a, let's say this is 1 second, this is 0.5 second. So for 1 second there is current, there is 0.5 second there is no current. So there is a current pulsation. Okay, so that is not wanted. Okay, we have to get rid of this problem. We want the current will be continuous. Okay, then what to do? So that though the circuit is will remain same, but we cannot use this circuit, okay, in practical, because of this pulsation in the current. We call it the ripple in the current and the ripple in the voltage. Technically, the difference, this is a minimum, this is a maximum, so difference is there, na? So that is called the ripple. Anyway, so we have to make this current ripple less. Okay, I mean less ripple will be there. So what to do? This can be done through this process. Let's use a inductor over here. Okay, so at this point we will put a inductor, and it will be something like that. Inductor, and we put a diode here. We put a diode here. So what will happen? Let us change the color. So whenever this switch is closed, the current will flow. Okay, through this the current will flow, and we can say right now this diode will remain in off state because of the reverse biased. So the inductor will charge, and the inductor will charge, the current will be this one. This will be the polarity, positive and negative. The current will charge, and essentially whenever this switch is off, this source is disconnected from this load side, and this inductor will now discharge, and the polarity will be, this side will be plus and this side will be minus, and the current will flow through this one. So inductor will discharge, inductor will discharge through this path. So what you will get, the current will be something like that. Let us draw it in different color. The current will start from here, it will increase to this, and then it will decrease. This may happen that the current will not totally come to zero, and then from here the switch is again closed. So up to this, up to T on, the current is rising, means the current is, the inductor is charging. So inductor is charging from this T on, 0 to T on. Then whenever the switch is off, the current will decay, and the inductor will discharge. Whatever the stored energy here, it will discharge. So the current will be something like that. At this point I want to mention one thing, whether you know or don't know, I don't know. So let us do it this thing. What I'm trying to say is that in a DC circuit, what happens, if there is a resistance only, what will happen? Let us say there is a switch. Okay, let us say there is a switch. So the moment you close the switch, current will flow. The moment you close the switch, the current will flow. The moment you open the switch, the current will be zero, and that current will be V by R. This is R, this is V. But this is not true for the case when there is a switch, again there is a R and there is L present in the circuit. What will happen? What will happen? The current will definitely be V by R. This is R, this is L, this is V. The current will be, this is a V by R. The current will be V by R, but it will take the shape something like that. This is V by R. So this is not instantaneous. At t equal to 0, the current was V by R. And at the t equal to some value, the current is again 0. But this will not be true for the case when there is a R and L. It will take some time to reach the R, V by R value. Okay, so this is we call the transient. This is a transient and this is a steady. Okay, and similarly, if you closed the switch at t equal to 0, you open the switch at some point, the current will instantaneously not be 0. It will take some time to decay. Okay, so whatever we are saying that whenever, now let us go back. So do you remember this thing? That is this, the transient part, and here this is this transient part. Okay, so the current is rising. The current is not fully decayed. The inductor is not totally discharged. It is like a, you can say this is like a bucket. Okay, you are storing the energy. Okay, you are storing the energy, then you are discharging the energy, then again storing the energy, again discharging. So the here in this portion up to T on, the energy stored here, in the inductor is like the bucket, and in the during the T off, it is not totally discharged. So some amount of energy stored here, then again it starts charging. So it will be something like that. Then it will fall something like that. Some moment will appear when this value and this value will be same, and this value and this value will be same. Meaning at steady state, during the T on, the energy stored in the inductor will be same as the energy released by the inductor. That is called the steady state. Physical significance of the steady state is something, this is a buffer energy. Okay, say this is constant in the amount, let's say the 80 joule energy is stored in the inductor, then 80 joule is transferred to the load. So this is something like that. That is called the steady state. Okay, so we will analyze the whole circuit in this steady state. Okay, so let us say one thing, that is one more thing, that is by selecting proper this time period, meaning the switching frequency and the value of inductor, we can make this sort of thing. That is the inductor current. We can make the inductor current something like that. Okay, let us do it once again. The inductor current will be something like that. Where is it? This may be the inductor current. Then it is to this value. Then again dropping to this value. Then again to this value. Then again dropping down to this value. So can you see one thing here? That is this value and this value are same. So what does it mean? It means that is a I max and this is a I min. Now selecting proper switching frequency, the L value, we can make this more flat, and in that case this will, the ripple will be lesser, but somehow this will be the nature of the inductor current. Okay, so what we can say, the L and this diode, they are making this current, they are reducing the ripple in the current, in the technical way we say. Okay, now about the voltage. Okay, so again we see there is a ripple in the voltage because there is a EDC voltage, there is a zero voltage, EDC voltage, zero voltage. So we need to reduce this ripple. In the ripple means this maximum and the minimum difference. Okay, so what we can do here, we can do this one. I'm erasing this R. Erasing means I will write it here, the R value. Why I have erased this one? Because I am going to introduce something here. Okay, I'm going to introduce something here. What I am going to introduce? Well, we will introduce a capacitor here. We'll introduce a capacitor here. See. Okay, now what will happen? This is very interesting. Whenever the inductor is charging, okay, the capacitor is the capacitor voltage is increasing, and whenever this switch is discharged, when this capacitor will supply the voltage to the load, meaning that the phenomenon that happened for the inductor current that I showed in the next slide, let us go back to that again. This is the case for inductor current. The same thing will happen for the capacitor voltage. You have this voltage source DC, and you have a voltage source means this one. You have this capacitor, okay? So the capacitor will develop the voltage, and that VC will be something like that. The VC will be, it will exponentially rise to V, and then it will exponentially fall. If we make a switch over here, and meaning that switch is here, okay? So this is the case. I hope you understood. This is a transient again. So we can say, if we see gradually, I mean, if we continuously make the switch on off, on off, on off, what will happen? This inductor, the capacitor voltage will be something like, and at the steady state, this will be something like increase, decrease, increase, decrease. So I will use this capacitor, okay? Here, we will use a capacitor here. So I will get the, we can reduce the voltage ripple in that way also. So basically, what is happening here, that is the DC voltage, this inductor, this capacitor is for the making the voltage, output voltage ripple free, and this diode, they are making this this sort of thing. Okay, so this is a basic chopper circuit. Okay, here I told you there is a V average coming to be delta into EDC. This is nothing but the buck chopper. We will discuss more about the buck chopper in the next lecture. So in a summary, what we learned here, let us have a recap. ED input voltage is EDC, and the L is there, and there is a capacitor LC, the filter in the outside output side, and this is a diode, and the concept of voltage chopping is this one. As because I'm chopping the voltage continuously, the name is evolved, so the chopper. Okay, so to make the current ripple less, what we need to do, we need to connect a inductor, and to make the voltage ripple less, we need to connect a capacitor here. Okay, so if you are having any question, you can put it in the comment box. And if you think that you have got benefited from the videos, so please like it and share it among your friends who are in need. And what else? Press the bell icon and subscribe the channel, so that when I will add more videos, you will get notified. Well, thank you. See you in the next lecture. Okay, thank you.